Now, do you want to do the mite rolls or do you want to skip those? It's optional nowadays.
Let's do them.
Okay. Last year, I was the only inspector. I mean, hired individual. They had my supervisor and my boss were out doing it, so that gave me only 1/3 of the state. Yeah, so I won't take full credit or blame.
Yeah.
You still judging chickens? Yeah. Good brood right there. All right, ladies. Down, down, down.
Don't say except four. That's not good.
Well, I'm always curious as to why something is doing what it's doing. If you look down in here,
okay,
this one's not too hard to pick out. It looks like they're digging out the pupal stage of something here for whatever reason.
Right. Now, these are those hygienic
bees,
so they have a tendency to kind of get rid of anything that's abnormal.
What generation are these, like, first or second?
They came out of Texas, weaver bees, last year.
Okay, and they're raising queens on you.
Yeah.
That one's got royal jelly in it, the other one has an egg sitting in it.
Let's see that up close. Yeah. And that's okay, because you know what? I actually need a swarm. there's a...
Unfortunately... This is the part I don't like.
Oh, you just broke the queen cell?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. They're rearing another one, so.
That one was unfortunately at the...
near hatching.
Of the pupal stage. Yeah. No.
Oh.
There's a ton of royal jelly still in there. It was hadn't consumed yet, but.
Let's get a close look at the royal jelly.
Have you ever tried it?
I know people do. I'm just not one of them.
It won't hurt you. I've tried it. It's a kind of bitter, kind of sour.
Yeah. All right.
You gonna try it?
No.
Oh, come on. Japanese eat it all the time. Eternal or Superman.
And if you note the queen in there anywhere,
yeah,
I would love to get a close-up of her.
I don't expect to find her on many of these frames because they're already laid up.
They swarmed 3 times last year. And I got a split off of them, but they weren't strong enough, and it was late in the year.
Yeah.
So, but they did give me a great video.
What I'll do is I'll drop back to that one and tore apart, and we'll shake bees off it instead of wrecking that queen that's starting here.
Okay.
She could have melted somebody with that one. Clear. Check for mom one more time. It's here. Try and replace a bunch that just flew out, and voila.
Good.
They're already raising the queen, so all you have to do is put 3 or 4 of these frames with cells on them in the hive. Thank you. nothing on that first sheet. Nothing on the second. This could get boring.
It's starting to look pretty clean.
They blew away my record for the highest mite count last year.
Well, they, who did?
Karen did. My boss now. They found one that went over 300 last year.
You're kidding.
I was disgusted. I said, now I've got to go and find one.
Now, you know, I don't treat this hive with anything.
They're doing exceptionally well. I mean, normally if you're going to find a mite, you'll find it in the first couple shades.
Yeah.
I'm going to say we're pretty much wasting our time here. One last one. Yeah. We're gonna call that one zero.
And then we go.
I don't realize what this job entails sometimes. I mean, look at the workout I get here. It's free. I don't mind them being there. I just don't want to stick my
now, do they eat mites, do you think?
No, they eat your bees.
They eat the bees.
Once in a while, they'll grab one and say, dinner.
What? All right.
This one's full. String make ugly face full.
A felony?
Yes.
This is the one I actually, last time I inspected, I pulled a bunch of honey off of it this year already. I guess they're just happy workers.
Well, we know mom's in here somewhere. We've got eggs.
Another.
Yeah, what happens is your original queen will slim down and take off with part of the colony, and then the first queen. Down, it put you. I knew it wasn't right. It put you on the left hand side of the street there, and I was like, oh, no.
You don't use GPS?
Not yet.
Oh, that's the easy route.
I don't want somebody yelling at me, turn left now! watch. I've done bees that are inside buildings with entrances arranged facing outward. Most of the time it's just a slot in the bottom of the building for the bottom board to stick out.
Right.
Some people will actually go to the trouble of cutting out to fit partial front.
The whole face. Yeah, the whole face is in there.
Okay. That was educational for myself.
What's that?
Stabbed myself in the finger.
Is that a drone on your cuff there?
Yes.
You can catch him.
You can have fun with those and hand them off to people.
Well, I know, and I was doing a swarm collection in Erie, and this little kid came running over that had, like, never seen him before, and I was like, want to hold a bee? And she was just, like, totally open. So that's a queen. What's the term for that?
As far as...
It's a grub, or... What do you call
it? Oh, this is, I would believe, a drone.
That's a drone.
Just at the larval stage.
Okay. And then the queen cell is?
That one makes me curious if you didn't have one hatch.
A queen already came out, maybe?
Because the capping's still dangling there.
Is this not a queen cell, too?
That is one also. So you may have a little virgin queen running around inside here.
Do they run around for a few days before they swarm, or what do they do?
Technically, what should happen is the swarm that was going to emit should have already happened, and then
now the bad weather would have kind of held them off, wouldn't it?
It may have, but you know, once again, when I quote some of these people, I know that bees are bees, and they're going to do what bees want to do, and you know. And the new queens tend to want to run in the upper area of the hive. She could very well even be in the upper box with all that honey. This one was already killed.
By another
queen. Or hatched.
Okay.
This one looks like it's...
Now, when they kill a queen, will the workers just clean that out and...
Yep, they'll just chuck it away.
Okay.
But anyway,
And this one's torn open. Now, does that mean this one will... Oh, is that just royal honey or royal jelly?
Yep, and I'm trying to... I can't see.
Oh, and this
see.
One's chewing out right here. This one's got a cap.
I don't know if you've got a viable queen in there or not. It looks kind of empty if you look
okay.
around the edges of it.
There's a queen cell with nothing in it.
Okay. Many times when I've pulled into somebody's place and watched them swarm from out of the box. Then I just have to leave a note. It's hard to do the ones the workers that are working on like here. Yeah, it's gonna be fast and furious, see if I can get them. It was about
the
wax on the frames.
The best foundation to put on it.
They will actually pay people to roll it. They'll get a big old pot of hot wax.
And dip them?
Take one of those little 6-inch weenie rollers.
Yeah.
And roll those frames. Yeah, I went down there the year Dave lost the majority of his bees. That was kind of sad. Okay, it was really sad.
Yeah.
Aha!
You found one? Where's it at?
Right there at the end of that door.
I see it.
Got him?
Yep. Right.
But I don't know about that claim. You would have to look into it. Wants me to do, go down to 8-frame mediums.
Why is that?
And they run them 5 or 6 right up the middle. Because they're just constantly working back into their own body heat. Instead of going sideways, they want to trend upward more. Mm-hmm. So we're thinking that with a 10-frame box, you're actually just kind of wasting your time and theirs by getting them to expand clear out here when they only use the center section to begin with.
Right, wow.
So you can cut down on weight, cut down on money involved to an extent, because then if you're not going this way, then you're going this way.
Right.
But in this way, you're going more with their natural progression for wintering to head up into the stuff. So.
Okay.
That was one of the aspects of...
What was the incentive to go to 10 frames in the beginning? Why did they even...
Langstroth came up with the idea. It was his baby back in the 1800s.
Yeah.
So... Evidently, let's face it, back then beekeeping, they did use the whole thing. Yeah. I can't begin to explain to you where the decline has started, other than possibly with the mites and things have gone haywire from there. But this is all supposition. I have no, but it seems like ever since, your bees are getting dumber. I see more and more bees that won't raise a queen. Or pack the hives out with pollen completely instead of honey. Dumb things like that. I mean, I've literally found entire boxes jammed with pollen.
The whole thing. And so no room for brood.
There's no room for honey. No room for honey. Yeah. And they're just dumb that way. And I think it's too many selective trait breeding issues.
Okay.
Just let them go back to what they were. Let them, level back out again. Quit selecting.